In this lecture series of silkworm, today we shall be studying important pests of silkworm. Among the different pests that affect silkworm, most important ones are oozy fly, tricholai, rhombicus, domestic beetle, straw mite, ants and nematodes, hexavermes, microaphids. Okay, so let us now see the first one, oozy fly. Oozy fly is very important pest of silkworm. To understand the economic loss caused by oozy fly, we need to understand its life cycle. So, the adult oozy fly, which is a dipteran insect slightly larger than house fly, is blackish grey in color. Body is blackish grey. There you will find broad bands, dark bands on the dorsal side of the abdomen. The female, after mating, it can lay up to 300 eggs. So, she lays one or two eggs on each larvae. The eggs are laid in the intersegmental region of the larval body. After this, what happens is, 1 to 3 days after egg laying, maggots of oozy fly hatch from the eggs. And these maggots, the red colored one that you can see, the maggots, they make hole on the body of the silkworm larvae. You can see black triangular marks and enter inside the body. They feed on the fat bodies of the silkworm larvae, and 3 instars grow inside the larval body. After 5 to 7 days, the last instar maggot comes out by rupturing the larval skin. Hence, the larvae dies. Okay, so here we can see that the oozy fly causes destruction of silkworm larvae. The oozy fly, if it lays eggs on the last instar silkworm larvae, that is the 5th instar silkworm larvae, during the last days, then that last instar larvae can spin a flimsy cocoon. But the maggots which are there inside the body of the larvae will transfer inside the pupa, will cut open the pupa and come out by piercing the cocoon. So such cocoons are also useless, they do not have any market value. So in this way, it is destructive to silkworm larvae, it is destructive to cocoons also. Now, what are the control measures? So, all the doors, windows, ventilators should be covered by fly-proof mesh. The room, rearing room, has to be fumigated. The leaves, mulberry leaves, that is harvested from the field, that has to be brought and kept outside on the veranda, and it has to be observed for oozy fly. Once you come to know that there are no flies, then only you can give those leaves to the larvae. Other than this, we can use spiders in the field to control this insect. Then the doors should have automatic closing system so that you don't forget to close the door. Another important thing is all the crevices should be closed. There should not be any crevices, any openings where soil is exposed, because the last instar larvae that comes out of the larval body of silkworm pupates in the soil where there is crevices and there is presence of soil. So when you close the crevices, pupation will not occur and you will not get adults. So this is about oozy fly. Now we move on to the next one. Second pest is the domestic beetle. This beetle has club-shaped antenna, small body, about 1 cm in length. Body color is black, elytra is black or brown in color. Now to understand the economic loss caused by domestic beetle, we need to
No, what it does, how it affects it in three different ways. So first is the dermacid beetle female can lay up to 150 to 250 eggs. So the female lays one or two eggs in the floss of the cocoon. Then from the egg, larvae emerges out and it feeds on the silk of the cocoon, thus destroying the cocoon. Again, second way how it is destructive is the beetles, adult beetles enter the drainages and there they attack the abdomen of the adult moth. And this is another way how they destroy the sericulture industry. And the third method is beetles, they are attracted towards the smell of stifled cocoons. So they enter the godown where stifled cocoons are stored and they pierce the cocoon and eat the larvae inside. So this is how they destroy the sericulture industry in three different ways. They destroy the cocoons, they destroy the adults, and they make pierced cocoons. Okay. Now, control measures. Control measures are, you should not keep discarded eggs, cocoons near the rearing house. Then the godowns, drainages, all should be covered with flyproof mesh, doors and windows, everything should be covered so that the insects cannot enter inside. And fumigation using methyl bromide. Fumigation using methyl bromide is very effective to control dermacid beetle. So the godowns, drainages have to be fumigated. Okay, so the third is stromite. Stromite is a carrion insect. Usually they are transported accidentally. They are transported accidentally into the rearing room. They are present in the fields. So along with bamboo, straw, they are accidentally transported into the rearing room. Now, how they are destructive to the silkworm? Female, after mating, it attaches to the body of the silkworm larvae. Okay, so it attaches to the body of the silkworm larvae. Sucks nutrients or nutritive fluid from the body of the silkworm. Okay, so because of this, the silkworm becomes lethargic. It becomes lethargic, loses appetites. When the stromite attached to the silkworm larvae, they not only suck the nutrients within the body, but also they release toxins, which are harmful to the silkworm. This lethargic silkworm over a period of time vomits green fluid and excretes black fluid and then eventually it dies. So this is how stromite is destructive to silkworm larvae. So prevention is prevention and control for that. What is to be done is you should not bring straw, bamboo from the field. Do not store these things around the rearing house. Then acaricides can be used to control the stromite. Okay, next insect pest is ant. So as we know, ants, they feed on the silkworm larvae. So what can be done is the rearing stands, legs of the rearing stands, under the legs of the rearing stands, you can use ant wells. Okay, so ant wells can be either circular or they can be triangular, and inside this kerosene water is added. So when the insects, any insects, even ants, when they are crawling inside, they will fall in this kerosene water and they die. Even in mountains, Chandrika mountain is there, even at the legs of the mountain, you can use ant wells to prevent the ants from entering the Chandrika and eating away and destroying the cocoons. The next pest is nematode. Many nematodes infect silkworm larvae, out of which the one that I am taking is Hexamyrmis. Okay, so what happens is when the larvae is infected by Hexamyrmis, the anterior region becomes transparent. Okay, so anterior region becomes transparent and posterior region becomes silky or white. This is because of the presence of nematodes inside the body. After a few days, the nematodes, they will pierce the skin or they will rupture the skin and they will all come out of the body and the larvae will die. So these are some of the most important pests of silkworm.